So I can put the video on me. Hello. There we go. So we're working this technology to be able to provide you with a lot more visual information, because a lot of things that we do are visual representations, because we're going to be asking for help. You know, promotion, just like these guys are talking about. Yeah, you know, promote the Facebook. Go to, you know, but it's not just words. I mean, it's actual deeds. We had this last weekend. The guys went up to Winslow on I-40 between, you know, it's kind of, if you looked at the top of Arizona and you go from the east border with New Mexico to the west border with California and Nevada, you'll see about a third of the way from the right is Winslow. You know, it's kind of halfway between the border and Flagstaff, which is in, kind of in the center. On I-40, this is it. If you look at a map and you're going east-west, a big giant hunk of traffic is going I-40. Now, there is a southern route, you know, which is 8 and 10, you know, down in the southern way, and that's more like going to San Diego, maybe a little bit of L.A. Then you have, you know, up towards the north, but you're going through what? I mean, no man's land, Nevada, you know, there's no population up there. So the vast majority of the trucking and traveling east-west is Interstate 40. We're talking millions and millions and millions and millions of millions, okay? So do we want to, you know, appeal to our own vanity? Go stand on a corner, put a bunch of stuff down here, build a billboard down towards the valley down here. Yeah, you know, we do a bunch of stuff like that. But always on top of our list, we want to infect as many minds as possible to whatever. We had Patriots for 9/11 Truth was the first one that paid for the billboard. Somebody wanted that up. Absolutely. Give you a year. Give you whatever. Done. Now we got a billboard. Then the next one, it was AE 9/11, you know, architects and engineers. They got a thing up there. All right, cool. Somebody paid for that. You know, do it. The guys, you know, made a little bit of money. They go change it out. Done. What they wanted was a Ron Paul. That's what eventually it came up. And the whole reason for doing this was to be able to support him in 2012. So this one doesn't say anything other than just Ron Paul. Does it really need to say any more? Seriously? Does it need fancy artwork or anything? No. Ron Paul. Billboard. Done. And a location that you can see on both sides of the freeway going east and west. So that, hopefully, is an inspiration for others to do the same thing, of just how much, like we did the billboard, you know, between Las Vegas and Los Angeles. The big pride, the blimp. There was a lot of criticism of doing the blimp. It wasn't cost efficient. You shouldn't have, yada, 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 yada. It was inspirational. It was opening the envelope. You know where the edge of the envelope is? It's way the heck over here. Way, way out here. That's where the envelope is. Can you be big? Big. I want to support guys with big. You can talk about it all you want on Facebook and stuff. You know, but that's not the end. That's just a tool of promoting the big. You think a Facebook posting is the big idea? No. That's how you promote it.
Arizona has been one of the hottest real estate markets in the past, up until the last couple of years. Homes that were once going for $500,000 to $1 million in prestigious areas are now going for less than half of what the original purchase price was. That makes it a very good time to buy. So if you were ever thinking of retiring to Arizona's inviting climate and laid-back and friendly lifestyle, now is the time. That's where I can help. This is Donna Hancock with Brangus Realty, and I have provided a way for you to search for properties that are of interest to you, all at your own convenience and without having to give out any personal information. Visit my webpage at DonnaHancock.com to start your search today. And when you're ready to make a move to Arizona's warm and sunny climate, please feel free to call or text me at 602-828-1819. Many are working hard to make sure Arizona is not only a beautiful place to live, but a free and peaceful one as well. So what are you waiting for? Make your move today by calling 602-828-1819. And don't forget to visit my webpage at DonnaHancock.com.
Agents of the state are threatening your freedom. Become a free agent and take it back. Google FR33 to get connected with other men and women around the globe who are united against state aggression and who are committed to not violent revolution, but peaceful evolution. It costs nothing to rally others to your causes by starting websites, creating and joining groups, and more. Stay up to date on the global movement for liberty by reading, watching, and listening to reports from our growing network of free agents. Free agents who work to achieve a free society can receive points for various activities which can be redeemed for gear, such as clothing, cameras, and more. When defending yourself against the state, be equipped with FR33 gear. You can directly invest in the projects that you care about right now so that free agents can get the valuable support they need. States are going to fail, so get off the sidelines and join other free agents on the front lines of freedom today by visiting FR33agents.com. That's FR33agents.com.
Do you want to support good people who disobey bad laws? The Civil Disobedience Evolution Fund was created to support the brave men and women who are saying no to aggressive government. With your contribution, you can support civil disobedience and non-cooperation now while encouraging more in the future. As cdevolution.org grows, we hope to provide activists with legal and public relations assistance, as well as delivering timely information on the growing civil disobedience movement. To play your part in the peaceful evolution, visit cdevolution.org. It's cdevolution.org.
Instead of just listening, you can also watch. See the Liberty Radio Network's key New Hampshire-based live shows via our studio cam at cam.lrn.fm. Plus, you'll still be able to listen to the Liberty Radio Network via the cam feed in high quality 24/7, even when there's no live show being produced in our Keene studio. But wait, there's more. Our chat room is built into the cam page so you can interact with other listeners online. Listen, watch, and chat, all free at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
To be a part of the show, call 602-264-2800. 602-264-2800. And now, Ernest Hancock.
Frank Haddad, H-A-D-D-A-D, Jr.
His father's a Shiite. We're checking him out.
His father is a federal agent. His father happens to be my partner.
Don't get in my face, Hubbard. I just might decide you're an Ethiopian.
You know, you are stupid enough to think that that's an insult.
Mistake's been made, we'll fix it.
If a mistake's been made, there's no mistake. I'm vouching for the kid. I want him out.
Let's get your priorities straight, Hubbard. I said we'll look into it.
Yeah, you'll look into it. Just like you've been looking into me, right? Surveilling me? You think I'm stupid? You think I don't know what's going on? I'm doing your job for you, and I damn near get my head blown off for it. Now, I want Frank Jr. out, and I want to see my prisoner, Tariq Husseini.
Let's go see your prisoner. How long have you been at it?
Not long enough, apparently.
How much longer do you think before he gives up the other cells?
He can't give up the other cells if he doesn't know where they are.
He knows.
No, he doesn't. You said it yourself, Sharon, didn't you? In the strategy meeting, the briefing, the one cell doesn't know where the other one is, right?
How long before he breaks, Sharon?
Well, at this rate, too long. The theater was hit 9 hours after we took down the first cell.
So, what other models do we have? Shaking. What about it, Sharon?
Won't work.
Works for the Israelis.
Only in conjunction with sleep deprivation. It takes at least 36 hours.
We don't have 36 hours. Electric shock?
The neurotransmitters just shut down.
Water?
Palestinian authorities producing good intel with water.
Of course, there's cutting.
It's extremely messy.
Are you people insane? What are you talking about?
The time has come for one man to suffer in order to save hundreds of lives.
One man? What about two? Huh? What about six? How about public executions, huh?
Feel free to leave whenever you like, Agent Hubbard.
Come on, General. You lost men. I've lost men. But you can't do this. What if what they really want... What if they don't even want the Sheikh? Have you considered that? Huh? What if what they really want is for us to herd children in the stadiums like we're doing and put soldiers on the street and have Americans looking over their shoulders, bend the law, shred the Constitution just a little bit? Because if we torture him, General, we do that and everything that we have bled and fought and died for is over. And they've won. They've already won.
Escort him out.
That is the movie The Siege, 1998. Where are we going? We're there. We're so freaking there. This is what I was concerned would happen, is that we become used to this kind of stuff. You know, heck, it's almost expected. You know, of course, you know, got water torture somebody. Gonna get, you know, say, and how does it get into our culture? You know, again, Kiefer Sutherland and the show 24 Hours or whatever, they're always coming up with some kind of justification for, you know, shredding the Constitution just a little bit. And people clap, even Liberty, yeah, man, woo, it's a great show. You even had presidential candidates referring to that series. It's a cultural thing. You know, and I was really happy to see Dr. Paul mention this in one of the debates when they were talking about how the laws and Roe v. Wade and abortion and medical care in the 60s started coming in with Medicare and Medicaid and the socialization of medicine. He remembers back when it wasn't and didn't have the problems that we got now and yada, yada, yada. And he's going, you know, the laws follow the culture. He goes, this whole thing is, you know, it's a cultural thing. You know, we need to have a change in the culture. The internet is a tool. It is not the culture. It manifests it. I mean, it demonstrates, it shows it, it reflects it. The culture is us. It's between our ears. Now, you can get a lot of, you know, ideas and change and expression and everything using the tool. But it's the end is not being on the internet. The end is not having your neurons stimulated and you're a rat. You know, in the case, I'll give you an example. There was an experiment. I can't remember what they called it. You know, you got like Pavlov's dog experiment where, and it kind of, you know, relates to that a little bit. Well, it's very Pavlovian of you. You know, what that means is I think it was in the 50s, 40s, it was a long time ago. It was black and white, let's put it that way. They had an experiment. Well, this one scientist, he had a German Shepherd, and he put him on a table, and he had a barrier. You couldn't see through it. On the other side, he'd have some meat or something, some food. And at the same time, he would ring a bell, ding-a-ling-a-ling, and then he would have the food there, and he'd pull up the partition, see the food, dog eat it. When you start thinking about food or you're thinking, oh, your mouth waters. Oh, that's mouth watering. I mean, just from a description. You could do a conditioned reflex to the dog. Could they condition them to salivate without the food? How would they do that? Well, they ring a bell every time and they lift it up and there's it. So he got used to the point that the bell meant food and they have a vial connected to this salivary gland and they just ring a bell and the dog would start salivating. Pavlovian response, conditioned reflex. Then you get into this other experiment that I thought was even more interesting. And it had an electrode that was sewn in, I mean, actually attached to the skull of a rat. I mean, you got these wires coming out of a thing in a rat's brain. What they were able to do is they flip a switch and it would stimulate the pleasure response, you know, like a little mini orgasm or something. Ooh, that was good. That was good. Don't do that again. So what they had is imagine a shoebox with a glass front in it, and you had the rat going from one side to the other, back and forth. And it was an electrified grid, like a screen, that was in the middle. And it was, you know, probably most of it there. But at the other end was a pad that he could stand up on and then flip a pad. When he hit that switch, it'd give him a pleasure response. But he'd only do it once. He had to go across the electrified grid to get to the other side to flip the switch again. Well, they'd go back and forth until they freaking died. I mean, get it? Then they start electrifying the grid. You know, 0.5, 1, 1.5, 2, whatever degree of whatever measurement they had. They just kind of kept amping it up. And it got to the point where you'd see the rat would be running. He's obviously being electrified. He's like, I'll get the other side. And he knows it's going to be more when he goes the other way. He might pause a little bit. Okay. Here we go. How much pain, discomfort, effort will you go through to get your little dose of ah? Well, if they can make the ah enough on the internet, how much will you stay in the matrix? How long before your intellect will overcome the pleasure response, and you understand what's going on? Ed Vallejo on the Billboard when we come back.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Stouffer's, helping bring your family together with wholesome dinner options, even on the busiest of nights. Find dinner table ideas to bring your family together at letsfixdinner.com. To get kids involved in dinner time conversation, ask specific questions, not broad ones. Instead of what happened today at school, try what was the best thing that happened today. The more specific you are, the more they'll have to say. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Did you know you can get news updates about what's happening with the Liberty Radio Network delivered in the way you prefer? You can sign up for our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. Plus, you can stay in the loop by joining our Facebook profile at facebook.lrn.fm or follow us at Twitter at twitter.lrn.fm. It's all free. So sign up now at updates.lrn.fm for news updates delivered to your email box, facebook.lrn.fm to follow our Facebook page, and twitter.lrn.fm to receive our tweets.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
Immigrating to the Shire was easy. I was instantly plugged into a community of individuals who also care about peace, liberty, and justice and are willing to do something about it.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com.
Hey, Ed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Go ahead and count to five.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
All right. There we go. Do it one more time.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
And that's how loud you're going to talk?
That's how loud I'm going to talk.
All right.
Now, don't get me agitated.
Yeah, I'm already pulling you down. All right, cool. What I want to do is, talk about, where this idea came from, how it got funded, who did it, who went up, made it happen, how hard was it, just kind of walk us through doing this. Because my point has been, I had the guys from Indianapolis, and they had a big opportunity like we did with the Super Bowl and everything, and they just wanted to make signs, go stand on the corner and go woohoo and have some fun. And I can see the difference between now and 08 in that now it's more of a kind of a, fun, social, selfish, almost like your particular church denomination hangout thing, as opposed to a movement, changing the planet, big idea, big blimp, big. And you guys went big. So I just want to, kind of show the difference,
Okay, well, there's
from Osiris.
I'm sorry?
There's a little problem. I don't know who funded it. I don't know who paid for it.
That's all right. Just tell me what you know. I don't care.
I'll tell you what I know. I'm not sure who paid for the banner or to be, you know, this guy, Tom McCauley, I guess. He owns the land. I don't know.
Now we'll just talk about the trip and everything. We'll find out what we know.
Okay.
Get closer. Gonna have my jug band back here, and Jasper, don't let me strum the washboard. We're gonna resort to cutting.
This is the Onion News Network.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Roads? It's the Ernest Hancock Show. Where we're going, there aren't any roads.
William Wallace, you stand in taint of high treason.
Against whom?
Against your king. Have you anything to say?
Never in my whole life did I swear allegiance to him.
It matters not. He is your king. Confess, and you may receive a quick death. Deny, and you must be purified by pain. Do you confess? Do you confess? Then on the morrow you shall receive your purification.
Yep, you receive your purification. I'm animated today. I see opportunities out there to go big, and go big. We got a message. The infrastructure is there. Everything is waiting. You know, the people have the material, the ideology, the education, the whole purpose is not to just, you know, let's just go gather, have fun, drink beer, which we do on a regular basis, by the way. But, you know, it's to actually change the culture. All the other stuff is side effect. All the vote totals and media coverage, side effect. If the big bad guys can get you thinking that their absolution of your position, that their forgiveness of you being impassioned, of their coverage, of their opinion, that anything they say matters one freaking rip for me, you know, then you already lost. Screw them. You know, we have the technology to bypass them. They are excited. You have 300-something million people in this country and a few million at tops watch together. MSNBC, CNN, and Fox News together, maybe 10. Oh, my God, it's the most important thing. Something flew into something, and you may get 20 million. You know, I'm going, seriously? And we care what they think? No. Manifest big. Well, I got Ed Vallejo on. He's a big kind of thinking guy. And I tell you, he's been involved in all the big stuff. He is the first on the front line. Show me how we can go big. You doing something big? I'm there. Let's go big. Big. Now, he also runs the meetup here. A lot of people, they want to talk and hang out. But when he's posting stuff, it's of them going big. You know, it's not like, hey, let's talk about how big we are and stuff on the internet. No, the internet's there to show how big we did out in the world, how much we jacked into the matrix for all the plugged-in people to see. A conduit into the message. Well, this last weekend, they waited till the Super Bowl's over. They won't watch Super Bowl. Yeah, they won't go sacrifice too much. But that means they're out on Monday. So, Ed, I got you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Help me out, man. You know, how did you know about this? What was going on? And all of a sudden, you guys decide you're going to go big. So what did you go do?
It is not heresy. I will not recant. I liked your intro there, Ernie. I got word from Morpheus, the famed Morpheus activist. He called me up and he said, "Hey man, I'm going up to put the Ron Paul billboard up. You know, let's go." I said, "Okay, I'm in." So we put it up on the meetup, and a couple more individuals jumped in, and the four of us. Okay, we got a crew of four. Three of us started out here in Phoenix. We jumped in the car. Left right after the Super Bowl and drove up to Prescott, where we picked up Trevor Osgood, another shaker and mover, and drove over to Chambers, Arizona, which is almost to the almost to the New Mexico border. It's right on the I-40. And took the materials over there and threw a ladder up and pulled down the AE-911 banner that was up there, and took us a couple hours, but we got wrestled the big ones up, and now 9 foot tall, 38 foot long Ron Paul letters on the freeway. It's so cool with the white background and the clouds behind it. When you're coming up on it, it looks like the letters are floating in the air. It's awesome. It really is.
So it's like skywriting?
It's almost like skywriting, I swear. You saw the video that I put up?
Yeah, we're trying to pull it up now. We'll make sure everybody gets to see it. We'll show it.
Yeah, as we're in the very beginning, as we're pulling up to it, you can see these. It says AE911.org. It looks like the letters are floating in the sky because the background's white and the clouds were white. It was just beautiful. I couldn't believe it.
What kind of response did you have from the people, you know, while you were doing this?
We had people honking at us as we were taking stuff out of the car. I mean, the minute we were on site, people were honking.
So they're familiar with this billboard. They know you're putting up something new.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. It's been about three different things so far. I think it was Patriots Question 9/11, and then they went and put something else up, and then they put the AE-911. That was the first time I saw that
one. You know, tell the people what you know of how this billboard came to pass, that we got this. You know, well, this is, I mean, it's such a prime location. And it's a beautiful, let me tell you, there's a lot of high winds up there throughout the year, and this sign's not going anywhere.
Oh, no, it's dirty.
I mean, it's telephone poles, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 telephone poles about 8 feet apart, and then it's tied, you know, they're sunk deep in the ground. They augered them in. Then they did, connected them with 2x4, 2x6s, you know, across, both sides sheeted with plywood. It has, I mean, I don't know how many sheets of plywood on there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10, 20, 25. It's like, you know, 25 sheets of plywood or more, you know. So this is never going anywhere. You know the dimensions. You have the vinyl done. We can change it and do whatever we want. Anybody wants some special message to go up there, boom, shakalaka, done. They give it to you guys. You go up there for a day, done. Done.
Right. From what I understand, this was maybe a year and a half, 2 years ago that they put it up. It's been up for a while now. The man who owned the land also had equipment for moving the poles, the flatbed for moving the poles and the crane, and had the auger, and said, hey, if you guys come up here and put this up here, we'll let you use our equipment, and all we want is 9/11 on it. As long as there's something 9/11 on it, we're happy. So activists went up there, built the thing, put it up, had 9/11 on it, went and switched it to a different 9/11, switched it to a third 9/11, and they were happy. They said, okay, great, hey, we're done. So that gave us the opening to put whatever we wanted to up there. I'm not exactly sure who paid for the vinyl to be printed, but it's that non-ripstop vinyl material that they make commercial billboards out of, and we got it strapped in and tied in and clamped in pretty much, and it's not going anywhere. I don't care how high the wind gets up there.
Well, as I remember, there's a gentleman that lives up there. He owns a bar, or he has some, I mean, the network was so much so that all the rental equipment, all the auger equipment, where we bought the actual material, you know, Shelton 4409, you know, hooked us up, and Tom Westbrook and Morpheus, they went up and built this sign in a day. And it was, you know, went up, we had some experience with how these looked in, when we went to, yeah, we're showing the video now, and this is you guys calling into the show, you know, where you're just getting there and getting started. That's Ed right there now on the video. You see him. Now, what we did is we wanted to make sure that everybody got involved and just had the opportunity. You know, everybody contribute. Everybody has something to offer. And this guy had land on the freeway. And he says, you get up here and do this, done. And we did. And it was so many people coming together to do things. We just, I want to inspire others to do the same kind of thing, because some people have the property. Some people have the side of the barn, like Terry Major up in Cottonwood, Arizona. He has this big main thoroughfare going through town. You go into Cottonwood, the small community up there, you're going by his house, and the whole side of the barn says, you know, Ron Paul, president, 2012, 2 years ago. You know, so this is, I want to inspire people to go big, big. You know the Facebook and the video that you guys sent out? It's of something other than you sitting at your Facebook.
Right. That's right.
You know, so tell us, you've been heading up the meetup here. You know, what's the evolution been? You know, well, that's a good question to hang on when we come back. I want to add to kind of share with us, you know, what it's like, you know, to be up close and personal with the people that have been involved in this from the beginning. It started here in Phoenix. And what's the evolution been? How's it changed? What are we looking forward to in 2012? How's it dealing with the party? What about the culture? All questions for Ed Vallejo when we come back. We know you're out there. We can feel you now. We know that you're afraid. You're afraid of us. You're afraid of change. We don't know the future. We aren't here to tell you how this is going to end. We're here to tell you how it's going to begin. We're going back to editing the next edition of Freedom's Phoenix Digital Magazine now, where we are telling the people what you don't want them to know. We're showing them a world without you, a world without rules and controls, without borders or boundaries, a world where anything is possible. Where we go from there is a choice we leave to you. Subscribe at freedomsphoenixeasy.com. That's freedoms with an S, phoenixeasing.com.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over halfway to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene.
Somebody must be watching Richard Gage, whatever, from AE Architects and Engineers is calling on the phone. Donna's dealing with him now. He wants to come on the show, so somebody must have told him you took a sign down.
you want to deal with him and I can talk to you another time? Or?
No. We'll have him come on later. I just want to let you know. I'm going to mention it when we come back.
Okay.
I'll be back in soon.
They'd rather keep their clients in the dark. There are too many lawyer jokes to count. However, there are some lawyers with more noble intentions. At the Institute for Justice, we bring the light to our clients. We are a nonprofit public interest law firm with clear values and principles. At IJ, we fight for those whose most basic rights are denied by the government. Visit our website today at ij.org.
If you can't listen to the Liberty Radio Network's internet streams, free satellite channel, or radio affiliates, no worries. You can listen to LRN.FM from any phone, anywhere. Add this number to your phone, 760-569-7753. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Liberty Radio Network listen lines are locked on our stream 24 hours a day. Call 760-569-7753. That's 760-569-7753. You've read books, listened to podcasts, attended lectures, surfed websites, and watched videos. You've made liberty your life's goal, but something seems to be missing. Stickers from libertystickers.com. Exercise your freedom of speech with the world's most dangerous bumper stickers. That's libertystickers.com. But wait. There's more. You can buy Liberty stickers wholesale. Get them for 99 cents each when you put 100 or more in your shopping cart in any combination. Sell them or give them away. They're great for gun shows, flea markets, fairs, outreach, and more. Earn extra money, promote freedom, and spread the word. Need custom stickers, labels, or decals for your organization or business? Liberty Stickers makes them. Go to libertystickers.com to order or call 877-873-9626. Libertystickers.com, the world's most dangerous stickers. You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
It's time for Declare Your Independence with Ernest Hancock.
Declare with me, Ernest Hancock and Vallejo from Meetup here in Phoenix, Arizona, IA, where it all started. The Livolution. Ed's been at all the main events and opportunities that we've had to jack into the Matrix. You know, I mean, you know, if you want to know something about something, ask Ed, because he's probably there and did it himself. Now, we go to the video of them putting up the sign and replacing it, the architects and engineers, AE911truth.org. And I guess somebody's watching, doing something. All of a sudden, I just got a call from Gates, from Architects and Engineers. They want to schedule an interview. Donna's dealing with it now. Have them come on. And I'm like, cool. You know, let's talk about it. You know, whatever. You know, let's get it on. Because they're going, hey, man, you took our billboard down? You took our billboard down? We're getting a whole bunch because you took our billboard down? So, yeah, we can do another one. Now, that's another thing is this. It could be big, giant billboard, Burma shave kind of billboard after billboard after billboard. You know, $5,000, man, we'll get it all taken care of for you. You know, $5,000, they'll give you however many months, you know, put that up and build it, and then we have another billboard. So that's one thing that Morpheus wants to make clear to everyone. He's like, look, man, you know, you guys want to, you know, be on I-40, just let us know. We can put billboards up all day, and the next day, and the next day. Now, did you feel uncomfortable taking A&E 911 Truth down? You know, you kind of like, well, you know, these guys had a good run. It's time to put Ron Paul back up. I mean, what were your thoughts on that?
Well, Thomas said something about they figured 5 million people a year saw that up there. So with the 3/9/11, they had 10 million views. Hey, it's our turn. Let us have 10 million views. We need that.
Everything I think that's kind of low, man. I'm thinking that's going to be a lot.
He said it was only based on an 18-hour day. And, man, those truckers are driving by that thing all night long.
Yeah, I'm thinking the numbers are even high. But anyway, it's a lot, millions. I mean, that's a lot. So we got Ron Paul up there, and it just says Ron Paul later as we get into this. It'll show you guys putting them up. We're just going to let that run. People will see that. And what they're seeing, you're talking on the phone, is you guys were calling in live to the show Monday while you're up there doing it. And so, you know, that was fun. I wanted to get to that one question that I asked, though. As we're going comparing 2008 to now, is there a difference in flavor? I mean, you know, what do you see as a difference in comparison from then to now?
Well, we're in a major metropolitan city of about 6 million people, okay? At the peak of Super Tuesday, I think we had like 1,200 people last time, okay? And it was people that were kind of in the know that already knew about Ron Paul for one reason or another, or were passionate about the Liberty movement. They were the core, okay? Out of the 1,200, there was maybe 300 people that were here local. All the rest were meetup groups from all across the country that were joining our group to see what we were doing, and then they were emulating that in other places, okay? I'm looking at the stats for our meetup group. We were the first meetup group for Ron Paul ever on planet Earth. We were founded January 20th of 2007, which was a little month and a half before he actually committed to running for president. Now I'm looking at the stats for the group for the whole period of time, and at the peak the week of January 4th of 2008, at the peak of what was going on for our group, we were getting about 45 people a day joining the group. At this point in time, we peaked just recently, the week of January 2nd, we had 225 people join in one day, okay? So we're exploding this time around. What we did last time
around... What's your peak? Do you have, how many people are on this site or linked to?
Currently, we have 1,116 members, but if I look at the activity of them, there's 300 members that have been consistently active since 2007. Now I'm talking active here continuously, even throughout the cycle. I mean, we have continuously had events promoting Ron Paul 3 years before the 2012 election. Why? Because, like Dr. Paul says, Freedom brings people together. People of all different walks of life, they all want to be free. And when they find out this is a freedom movement and it's trying to get everybody to be free together, it brings them in and they become family. And once you become a part of this family, rarely do you leave. I mean, we've had all these people since, I've only had to ban one person, and that was just some person that was just kind of a wacko that wanted to just inflame things. I don't know if it was somebody trying to insert themselves into our system or not, but it doesn't work. You can't infiltrate a family that's doing the right things for the right reason.
You know, I've seen it. My real observation is, because, we've been activists for a long time.
Yes, sir.
And I know you were a big supporter of Michael Badnarik. In the 04 election cycle, and it got you going, and it was an easy segue into support of Dr. Paul. And this is our experiences have been. I see a difference. The difference this time is more. It's like you have missionaries out there for Christ to save the world from the heathenistic, whatever, and culture, and the light and the way. And then you have people that, as time goes on, they're more concerned with their individual church and who's in charge of, having the meetings and ouch, quit it, and you're not allowed and everything, and breaks into denominations and you're on the church on the corner kind of thing. And I'm starting to see that where before it was a passion for, the message, the love, and so on, now it's starting to compartmentalize into everybody's little, what they're doing. And I'm trying to, is that a natural effect? Can that be used to the greater message? Or because that's why I never wanted to join any collectives. I never went to C4L. I never wanted to be part of Ron's campaign. Because I always see this always happen. And if you don't seize it early on to be part of changing the culture, then you'll forever be lost down the dark hole of my collective's bigger than yours. And it's here we still have a lot of people doing a lot of things, and the inspiration that you do by the leadership of you guys going up and putting up this sign, I'm hoping will inspire others to start thinking big and doing big things, because we can get creative. We can do a lot of, creative, set the bar stuff. But
Ernie, I'm thinking about the airport entryway from the east and west coming into the airport, and I'm looking at satellite pictures trying to figure out open spots of land where we can go out and either paint the ground or do something so we can have a big, people look at the billboard and say, oh, that's big. No, I'm talking big, where you can see it from the plane as people are taking off and landing.
Oh, now we've talked about this, and there's one method that you can grid it out. And you plant wildflowers, and the first rain that hits here in the spring, next month or two, and it hits it rains, boom, all of a sudden you got foliage, and that's one way of doing it. We were thinking a lot of different, you want to do that, I'm in, man, I'll help, maybe we can raise some money and go get some seed grid, because you're right, they're going into, the landing pattern as they come in and going out. When you're landing, you see this big open desert next to the riverbed there and so on. It's just dirt. You go putting stuff and it rains one time, all you got to do is just do it and walk away and just wait. It'll be someday, and then it's time to, take a plane trip. And it's good, if that's something you're big in on, you want to do that, I'm in. Let's do it.
Well, I would paint the ground that says Ron Paul, but for flowers or something like that, I'd want to do it somewhere out between here and L.A. in one of the big patches of land where we could put freedom or liberty,
Okay.
Hey, I'm all for it.
Matt, you come, I'm in. You take charge of it. I'm in.
Excellent. See, that's how easy it is, people. That's how easy it is.
That you just saw it done. But somebody always has to take charge of the big idea. Got to be, if you were the only person doing it, would it still happen? Yes. Ed's one of those guys. I'm one of those guys. I know that if we do this, it's going to happen. Because we'll make sure it happens. But the more people that benefit, that help, the more that benefit. It's easier. It's funner. But big. Think big. Where's the big? I want big. And if you need somebody to show you how to do big, Ed and I can show you We got more Big coming. We'll be right back in hour three.
Free Talk Live.
Thanks, Ed.
Yes, sir. Anytime.
Yeah, that'll work. I'm